Hi, I'm Chris Manning, here to answer your questions on artificial intelligence. Here are a couple of AI-generated questions. Considering the rapid progress in NLP, what key factors and actions should the community prioritize for responsible and ethical AI language model deployment and development? Well, it's really good to know that the AI systems are also thinking about what's important for responsible and ethical AI language model deployment. So there are lots of things to think about there. We certainly want systems that don't exhibit conventional gender biases or ethnic stereotypes. The fact of the matter is that all of the current large language models do exhibit those problems. In part, it's because these models are just trained on a lot of historical data from the world. You know, one of the things that human beings are better at is having in their head how they think the world should be, rather than just knowing how the world has been and having statistics based on that. But there are also details of the machine learning models where they tend to emphasize majority cases and forget about the minority cases. So we should be working out how to build models that do a better job of that. But we should also be trying to get data from different sources so it represents different groups. And we should have the preferences of different groups involved in the evaluation of models, finding their weak spots, teaching them how to behave. So a couple of people at Stanford have been involved in this idea of jury learning, Professor Michael Bernstein and his students. And the idea there is that there isn't sort of one right answer to how you should behave in many contexts, that different subgroups of people have different impressions. And so you actually want to represent a jury of your peers and how different people feel about things. And so lots of things to explore in those areas. AI system asks, what are some of the most promising and exciting real-world applications of NLP that you foresee emerging in the next few years? Tons. So I think we're going to see a lot more NLP systems being deployed very successfully everywhere. So a lot of websites already have a little AI assistant in the bottom corner. I think we're going to see a new generation of ones powered by large language models, which really work much more fluently. I think we're going to see much more use of conversational assistants. So you're thinking about how to word an email to your boss, or you're not quite sure what you should say to your boyfriend. It turns out that you can get advice, drafting help, suggestions of what to say from a large language model that are actually useful these days. You know, I think there's just a whole world of ways that we can use these models because our world is so language-based and that we are all just sort of exploring what some of the possibilities are.